YouTubers. I'm glad you're all here. Today is Friday, September 16th, 2022. One of my friends and followers there on YouTube sent me an email about the activity that's been happening there at a super volcano in New Zealand, Lake Taupō. GeoNet is reporting an increase in earthquake activity under Lake Taupō. Maybe about 350 to 400 earthquakes has been happening there. Lake Taupō is a large caldera volcano, a special type of volcano that has rare but unusually large eruptions. This activity is similar to recent periods of elevated earthquake activity and ground deformation that was measured in 2008, 2009, and 2019. They don't have any permanent seismic monitors there at Lake Taupō. It is a very popular tourist destination. There's all kinds of lake activities, parasailing, you name it. Yeah. This year, five clusters have been active beneath the center part of Lake Taupō, north of the lake. And I'm not going to try and pronounce the locations. I'll show you on Google Earth. I marked out some of the more recent earthquakes within the last 3 days. And then there was also a 4.4. That showed uplift. And let me bring it out for you. All right. And we'll come out a little bit more so you can see the different names of the different areas. And we'll come in to this area where the recent earthquakes have been ongoing. Like I said, this is from the last day to maybe 3 days. And then up over here, yeah, that's a fairly large city. They got all kinds of things going on here. We got Great Lake Holiday Park. They have Taupō kayaking adventures. Mine Bay rock carvings. Let me show you those. I haven't looked up the history of these rock carvings. I got another one to show you. They look like lizards right here, and looks like another one was being worked on. And then let me bring this in because there's more up here on the rock face. And I'll bring it in so you can see it. Almost looks like Aztec type of drawings. I got an arm right there. And might be another face. Now, according to GeoNet, the area under Lake Taupō, both inside and outside of the caldera, have been seismically active since 2000, with just over 5,000 earthquakes located by their instruments. The earthquakes this year have ranged in size from about a magnitude 1.0 up to a 3.6. Well, they've had more recent ones since they were interviewed. This 4.4, which was on the 9th of this month. And then there's another one that's come down over here, which was a 4.2. That one, that one was actually last year, January 4th of last year. But this earthquake actually made the papers there in New Zealand. People described the earthquake as quite scary. One said it damn near rocked them out of their bed. Another said they were watching TV and everything was shaking. Picture frames fell over and everything rattled. So strong, another user had said. More than 1,200 Kiwis reported it to GeoNet. Here on GeoNet, they have a list of many of the earthquakes. Currently, the alert level is zero. And let me go zoom in on this so you can see some of these earthquakes. Yeah, they're mostly clustered over here by State Highway 1, it says. And I'll show you. See, now this one here was on September 10th. And we'll go back to some of the older ones. July 21st, 2.2. I'm just going to jump around. July 31st, a 2.1. A 2.1 on August 19th. August 4th, a 1.2. 3.2. Now that was September 15th. That would have been just yesterday. 1.7 September 10th, etc. It looks like the deepest one that they have marked here was on September 11th, a depth of probably 17 kilometers, which is about 10 and a half miles, and that was a 1.8. And let's see, the next deepest one would have been this one on September 7th, 14 kilometers in depth. So that would be about 8.7 miles in depth. And I believe this would probably, that was a 1.4. They got a 1.7 on September 11th, 10 kilometers in depth. That would be somewhere around 6 miles, I believe. Currently, they classify this volcano as dormant, not extinct. And it is considered a super volcano. The caldera is a large rhyolite super volcano. Its first eruption was about 300,000 years ago. There was another eruption 26,500 years ago. And it says its last major eruption was 10,000 years ago. They consider it currently volcanically active. And you've got the different dates of the eruptions here. And let's bring this down a little bit if I can. There we go. This is a very dangerous volcano because it erupts rhyolite, viscous magma with a high silica content. Yeah, the most dangerous type of magma, lava, that you can have because it's so full of gases. Yeah, it contains much gas. And it says here, if the magma does not contain much gas, rhyolite tends to form a lava dome. However, when mixed with gas or steam, rhyolite erupts, can be extremely violent. The magma froths to form pumice and ash, which you can throw out with great force. They have an image here showing a map of the areas where the different eruptions had occurred. And yeah, this one right here at the top right. And probably these three here are where the current earthquakes have been occurring. The eruptions went through several stages. A minor eruption occurred beneath the ancestral Lake Taupō. Then there was a dramatic increase in activity produced by high eruption columns from a second vent, and pumice was deposited over a wide area. Water entered the first vent and mixed with magma, producing a white ash rich pumice fall. A new vent then formed and produced a dark ash and obsidian rich ash fall. The most destructive part of the eruption then occurred. Part of the vent then collapsed, unleashing about 30 kilometers or 7.2 cubic miles of material that formed a fast moving pyroclastic flow that was probably traveling close to 600 to 900 kilometers per hour. So that would be about 300 to 500 miles per hour. Yeah, no one could outrun that. Rhyolite lava domes then were produced some years later, which formed some reefs in the area. And then there was smaller eruptions of unknown total size that created large pumice rafts. The power of the pyroclastic flow was so strong that some places were actually scorched, scraped clean of everything that was there. All vegetation in the area was flattened. Loose pumice and ash deposits formed lahars down all the main rivers. So going back to Google Earth, you can see some of the rivers and the lahars that probably traveled down through there, flattening everything, absolutely everything. And it also enlarged the lake during the last major eruption. So thank you for sending me information about the recent activity there. We'll just have to keep an eye on it. What are your thoughts? Please put those comments down below. Thank you very much for watching. Thank you for subscribing. Please stay safe. And I will talk to you later. God bless y'all. Bye.